doing anything else. I think they're all a lot better. So we do have the opportunity that if you sort of throw yourself into this Zoom experience, you can do things like sing your part alongside the teaching parts of the other parts, you know, which gives you the opportunity to do more and more practice. And hopefully we'll get a bit better at teaching on Zoom because it's a whole new experience for us too. But there are some advantages. Okay, so we get to do more songs and we can have a 90-minute session, which is great. So we're going to start with Bridge Over Troubled Water. You will know this if you've come to the Zoom session on the Tuesday night. It's in two parts, so you've got to decide now what part you're going to be in. Is there any guidance for this? Is it high, part one?
Not
yes,
really.
It is. Part one is the old high note.
Nothing as high as on one.
You'll be fine.
Yeah, after On My Foo, you'll be able to sing all the notes.
It's in two parts, I'll do part four.
Yeah, Chris. Chris, you'll be doing part two, I suggest. Then the typical makeup is altos, baritones, your part two, and sopranos, tenors, your part one. So that's, we'll assume that's what you've chosen. If you tend to be a soprano stroke alto, I'd go for part two.
Oh, so soprano is part two?
No, you've got the choice. Because our soprano section, we have a lot of singers in the soprano section. And so with these two-part songs, if you're a soprano, you can sing either part one or part two.
Oh, I see.
And the part two line is not low, it's an alto, it's a typical alto baritone line. So if you are a soprano, you won't have any trouble with it. Whereas obviously sometimes if we're asking sopranos to sing a tenor line, or like Lynn has just sung the bass line, personally, I think you can all do it, but it's good for your voice. But sometimes I think it's really fun to sing a harmony part rather than a tune part. So if you're a soprano, you often are singing the tune. So it's why I ended up being an alto, because I didn't want to sing the tune all the time. But I'm not really an alto. Anyway, blah-de-blah, pick a part, one or two. And to start off with, the beginning section, we're all mostly singing the tune. So we will take you through the tune just to make sure that there isn't anyone making up their own version of it, which will end up sounding scary when they're in choir. Oh, we have a backing track for this. Tracy, if you learn the piano. We'll do it just with the piano to start off with. So, first bit. Well, everyone together is singing it.
Singing it low.
Oh, yes, sopranos. Oh, yes, this is the tricky part, sopranos. About this beginning section, you are singing an octave below. Okay, so you're singing right down here. When you're weary. And that lowest note is going to be a challenge for you if you're a soprano. So I'll sing that first line. I'll sing the first two sections and then you can sing it back to me. It goes like this. When you're weary, feeling small. Lift in there that isn't in the music. Feeling small. Okay, it's feeling small. So everyone is singing this. That's everyone. When, and do not sing an octave above that. Keep it in that lower register. You will get the chance for our nose to go up later. I'll count you in for two, three. Two, three.
When you're in.
So Chris, if you want to sing where Andy's singing, that would be fine, an octave below, or we all just sing in the same register. And then the next line goes like this.
When tears are in your eyes.
And I added a little flourish of my own that isn't there.
So this is just part one, group one.
Oh yes, this is a little harmony here. This is just group one. We're staying in the lower register. It goes like this.
When tears are in your eyes.
Have a go. And.
When tears are in your eyes.
If you're group two, you have this.
When tears are in.
Whereas some, no, group two, have a go. I'll count for two, three, one. Two, three, one.
When tears are in your eyes.
And that sounds lovely, that drop down, if you could remember to do it. Right, let's have everyone together doing that. When, count for two, three, one. Two, three, one.
When tears are in your eyes.
See how lovely that sounds, if you remember to do it. And then the final line, if you're in group one, you've got to choose whether to do the lift at the end. Okay, if you are not a controlled soprano, don't do it. Okay, if you are a soprano, a controlled soprano, then just do it very gently. It goes like this.
I will dry them all.
You have a jump of an octave, and you need to be able to do it cleanly and with no sliding. We don't want any of this. Oh, no, that's really horrible.
I will dry them all.
We're holding it for two. So you hold your lower note for two and you hold your higher note for four. Do it one more time.
I will dry them all.
Okay, so group one.
On all part two doing that, on just some of us?
This is part one, Chris.
I'll go back to sleep then.
Yeah. If you're part one, then you have a choice of doing that lift at the end.
I'm not part one, so I'll just shut up.
Yes, you can just stay down at the low, which is the same as part two. If you're part two, you're just doing this.
I will dry them all.
So you just hold that final note for six. So Chris, you could probably do that. So you've got the choice. If you know as a soprano that you can make that leap cleanly, so you land on the right notes with no sliding, then do it really quietly. Everyone else just stay on the same note for six. So let's do that. And this is everyone. I'll count you in for two, three. Two, three.
I will dry them all.
Have a go from the beginning.
When,
and it's honestly, it's so easy, sopranos, to start an octave higher. Which is really not.
I'll join you, Chris, down at the bottom.
Okay, so we'll have a little go with the backing track, which has quite a long introduction.
And I'm doing part two.
I'll do part one. Oh, that's you! I thought that was something strange going on.
I need to practice.
Disconnected. Yes, right. What was I saying? If I don't check it, it isn't on. If I do check it, it is on. Right. Big long introduction.
I'm on your side. Like a bridge over
concerns. Like a bridge over troubled water.
Okay, don't forget that. And then we sing group one, you're going to sing.
I will lay me down.
You're going to add that on.
I will lay me down.
Here we go, and.
I will lay me down.
And if you're in group two, you have.
I will lay me down.
Which is the tune. Have a go, group two, and.
I will lay me down.
Okay, let's see if we can put that together. I'll sing one, Tracy's singing two. Three, four, one.
I will lay me down.
Okay, now I'll sing two. Two, three, one.
I will lay me down.
And so Chris, you should be singing with Andy if you're in group one. Or are you in group two?
He's in two. He's in two.
He's in two. Two, okay. Well done. And then we go on, oh, we know we ought to add that on to the Like a Bridge Over Troubled Water. So let's sing Like a Bridge Over Troubled Water, I Will Lay Me Down. We'll just do part one, and then we'll sing all the way through part two, and then we'll put them together. So we'll just sing in part one to start off with. If you're in part two, do feel free to practice your part if you think you know it well enough. Okay, from Like a Bridge. Like, okay, if two, group one. One, two.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Well done, group one. Now we'll do group two.
Like,
two. One, two.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Okay, let's put that together then. So shall I sing one or two then? We'll do it twice. That's okay, so I'll sing one the first time, two the second time.
Like.
Okay, anyway. Monday morning, tunelessness.
Like.
Okay, for two. Two.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Okay, now I'll sing part two.
Like.
One, two.
Like a bridge over troubled water.
I think it works with a tenor on the tune. I think it sounds nice. Anyway, then the next bit, let's see if we can get you through to the end of this section. Now, I don't think I'm going to be able to. We've got 7 minutes. That's a bit of a... Anyway, let's see how we get on. Next bit, group one, is...
Like a bridge...
What was it saying?
Like a bridge over troubled water.
So that's the same. You'll be fine with that. And the last bit is...
I will lay me down.
So you do have to remember to do that. You have to come down at the end.
I will lay me down.
Have a go and.
I will lay me down.
And obviously the first time you sang I will lay me down, you went up at the end. The second time you sing it, you go down at the end. But the backing track will help you remember that. As will your conductor. And if you are in group two, you have a choice of notes. You can either sing this.
I will lay me down.
Like a bridge, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Nah.
We know you've got a wobble. You've got a
wobbly bridge.
A wobbly bridge. You have this, group two.
Like a bridge.
There are four notes in that trill.
Like a bridge.
Have a go.
Like a bridge.
And again.
Like a bridge.
And I do want you to try and sing all four notes rather than just go
like a bridge.
Do it nice and cleanly. And then it carries on.
Over troubled water.
That's the same as the previous section. And the end is,
I will lay me down.
If you're feeling confident, you might sing,
I will lay me down.
And we make a three-part harmony, up to you, or just sing the tune.
I will lay me down.
Up to you. So let's go from Wobbly Bridge, part two.
Lie.
Now I will sing, okay, of two. Group two. One, two.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Ta-da! Right, so let's have everyone singing the whole of the Like a Bridge of the chorus. So we'll go from the first one and then into the second one.
Like.
So I'll sing one, Tracy singing two. Are you singing one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like.
One, two.
Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Hold that for 4.5. Okay, shall we see if we can do it all the way through from the beginning with the backing track? Yes.
Feeling small.
Oh, well, we're having a nice time. Although obviously missing you all, it's a different experience, but I think important that we sing.
Right. Well, you're more than welcome to come.
More than welcome to come tomorrow at 8 o'clock.
And you can smugly know the parts that no one else knows.
Yes.
Plenty of time to forget them between now and then.